Hey, this is Ralph. We got four down, two to go. Working on these web page layouts. We did layouts one and two. They were one column layouts. Layouts three and four are two column layouts. Layouts five and six are three column layouts. Alrighty, so where did I leave off? I've got a two column layout. I did a sidebar there on the left, and now I've got a sidebar on the left and a sidebar on the right, and then got this middle section. Let me show you one of the multiple ways you could make this. By the way, always preface, know that when I demonstrate something, it's not like it's the only way to do it. You can watch or learn tutorials or read different books, and you might see, several different ways, equally good ways, in order to make a particular layout. So let's see, I'm going to change this out. I'm going to have sidebar one. Check this out. I'm going to do a div ID sidebar 2. I'll kind of spell it correctly though. And I guess we'll do sidebar 1, sidebar 2. And then I've got my header and my main section. But I'm going to mix this up a little bit. This is a technique I like because I think it simplifies things. They say, oh my gosh, it gets confusing. I'm making a three column layout, yet there's four things. Well, what if I did this? Div ID equals center. And I put a closing div down here. So just kind of ignore the fact that there's a header and a main and treat it as a true three column. There's my left column, my sidebar one. There's my right column, my sidebar two. And here's my center column. Okay? Just so happens it has some stuff inside of it. Don't worry about that though. Sidebar one is going to float to the left. Sidebar two is going to float to the right. My center column is going to squeeze right up in between the two automatically. It's going to be pretty slick. So let me go ahead and save this. Call this layout. I saved over my layout four. Can you believe that? So I'm going to call this layout. If I'm going to hit the right button, I'm going to call this layout five. Change my title. Layout 5, and I'll do a file save as layout 5.html. So I just deleted basically my layout 4, but live and learn, right? So now I'm going to kind of tackle this. In fact, I think I'm going to clean this up a bit. Let's just delete all that. Okay, I'll still keep that container in there, but let's see, I've got my sidebar 1, and that's going to be floating to the left. Background color green and a width of 200 pixels. Good, good. I'm going to copy that, paste. Sidebar 2 is pretty much the same, except it's floating to the right. Now I've got this center column to deal with. My center. I don't really care about it. In fact, I don't even need to really do anything here. Okay, my center column doesn't need anything. It's already got the header in the main section, but I do have to deal with those. My header, I'll do a height of 80 pixels, background color of red, and that is it. That's it. That's it. And then, of course, then I have my main section where all my content is going to be. I'll set a height on that of, let's see, what was my height on my sidebars? Ooh, I didn't set a height on my sidebar, so I will want to go back and do that. How about 400 pixels? I'll do the same. 400 pixels. Since my header is 80, I'll do a height of 320 pixels for the main. I'll do that little trick too. Since my sidebar and my my left one and my right one are 200 pixels, I'll go ahead and take care of this. Margin left 200 px. Margin, let's just do it this way. Margin 0 px top and bottom, 200 px left and right. Can't be any easier, can it? Okay, I'm going to save this, run, launch in Firefox, and there's my three column layout. Now my main section, did I not color that blue? It actually looks transparent there, and that's the background color of my page. So let's make sure, nope, I didn't put a background color. So go back, refresh, there we go. So there's my three column layout with a sidebar on the left, sidebar on the right, header section, main section right there in the middle of it. So make sure you get a gander at this. keep the HTML as simple as you can. I've got my left column, got my right column, and then I've got my middle column. Just because my middle column had some stuff in it doesn't matter. Alright, so that takes care of that one. Since we can do that, our next and last layout should be pretty easy. The key difference here is, well, let's do a little bit of modification. My header is all the way across the top. So, let's try it this way. I'm going to take, before I forget, I'm going to go ahead and call this layout 6, go up to my title, layout 6, file, save as layout6.html. Alright, let's work on layout 6. So in layout 6, we've got, just kind of ignore the red for a second, ignore that red header up there. And what do we have down here at the bottom? Well, we've got a 3-column layout. We've got a sidebar, a main, or center column, and then we have our sidebar. Therefore, I could take the header out of the center, and I'm left with sidebar, sidebar, center. Happens to have a main in it. My header is all the way up here at the top. It's above those sidebars. First thing that occurs, so I'll just run back here. Div id equals header. And that should take care of it. All right, let's see what happens. If I save this, run, launch in Firefox, look at that. Now the only thing off, of course, are my heights, because that header is up there near the top. My heights on my sidebars are a little bit off, or I can make my main section a little bit taller, 400 pixels or so, right? So I can head back to my code, take that main section CSS, and instead of 320 tall, make it 400 tall, back to the browser, refresh, and there we go. So that is my last layout. My header is across the top, sidebar, main sidebar, but in the HTML, header is across the top, sidebar on floating left, sidebar floating right, center column slides up right in the middle. Now because my center column doesn't have any formatting, I did not have to put in this blanks, and I did this on my last video, I think. Or no, I guess I did it a second ago. Getting mixed up here. Technically not, you know, not even necessary. If you're not going to have any declarations in a CSS rule, you don't need the CSS rule. So I can take that out, head back to my browser. If I can find my browser, let's get rid of that. There it is. Refresh, no change. You got yourself a good looking 3-column layout with a header. If you wanted that footer down there, hey, sure you can do that, right? Just slap a footer on there. Let me jump over to editor here real quick. Since my main is down here. Now to get a footer down there, what I might do, check out this little trick. Head over to my HTML real quick here. Put a div, and another div. There we go. And then I can format that footer however I like. In fact, I can go ahead and take the rules that control my header and also control my footer. It's a grouped selector right there. Save that, browser, refresh. Now you got a header and a footer. Look at that, 3-column layout, header and footer. So don't make layouts more complicated than they have to be. And know this, once you get good at creating some basic layouts, 1-column, 2-column, 3-column layouts, a few variations of each, you've got every web page layout known to man. All right, have fun.